Students, here second example that this pie graph represent that the soya span time for the various activity during the whole day. So here you can see this pie graph, the circle graph is divided into unequal part and it shows the different activity. Yes. So these are the activities: study, watching TV, playing tennis, eating, playing tennis, eating and reading. So these are the activities Zoya spent her time during the whole day. Now you can we will see this pie graph and on that basis we will answer this question. So you can see here that the majority part she spent the time on study. Okay, and here the rest of the time divide into this activity. So let's see this first question: which activity takes up Zoya's maximum time? So Zoya spent maximum time for which activity during the whole day? She does so many activities. So out of this activities, study are its this pie graph span here the majority part here studying activity. So she span here which activity? So study, Zoya spent her time maximum. Zoya spent her maximum time in study. Next question: which activity is the least time consuming? Least time means very less. She spent here, you can see, eating. So that means she is very good girl. Why? Because nowadays many students have the bad habit while they are eating or taking a lunch, dinner or breakfast, they spend more time. Why? For this eating activity, because while they are taking the dinner, lunch or breakfast, they watch TV and it takes more time. So that also you can understand she is here the less time consumed in eating. Okay, next question: which two activities take up the same time? So the pie graph, these two activities are same? No, these two parts are same as. So we can say that playing tennis and watching TV are Zoya spent for these two activities for the same time.